Students, welcome to CBSE class 12 2020-2021 political science. Okay, hope you are all doing well and in good health. So let's get started. Best card books for political science, you know, first one is contemporary world politics, second one is politics in India since independence. Today I am going to teach you the first chapter of the first book, that is the Cold War era. Before starting this chapter, you have to remember 11 factors of this, so that after listening to my video, when you will go through the textbook, it will be easy to understand. Okay, first, background of the Cold War, Cuban Missiles Crisis, what is the Cold War, the emergence of two power blocks. Why was the Cuban Missile Crisis a high point of the Cold War? What is the logic of deterrence? Why the superpowers needed to make allies with smaller countries? The aliens of the Cold War, challenge to bipolarity, new international economic order, India's policy during Cold War. Okay. Now the first point is, how did the Cold War start and its background? Before understanding this point, how did the Cold War start and its background, you have to know what is Cold War. Okay. The Cold War was a series of tension, conflicts and confrontations between the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, USSR, or the Soviet Union, and the United States and their respective allies, Eastern Bloc and the Western Bloc. It started after the Second World War, 1945 to 1991 period of time, after the end of the Second World War. Okay, now how did Cold War start? The Cold War was an ideological conflict between the United States and the Soviet Union. It means capitalist democracy versus socialist communism system of ideology. It was during World War II. These powers were close allies. Okay. During World War II, the Allied powers were USSR, Britain, France, Spain. The Axis powers were Germany, Italy, and Japan. The Allied powers owned the world and Axis powers lost the war. Next point is Cuban Missile Crisis. So, what is Cuban Missile Crisis? Cuban Missile Crisis, a direct and dangerous confrontation occurred between the United States and the Soviet Union in 1962. Students, please remember, 1962, during the Cold War period, both the two superpowers came close to a nuclear conflict. Okay. Now, the point is, why it was dangerous? Because this time two superpowers came very close to a nuclear conflict, what was very dangerous for the entire world? The crisis evoked fears of nuclear destruction, revealed the dangers of Cuban Missile Crisis. Now, come to the point. What is Cuban Missile Crisis? Cuba is a small country with smaller islands. Okay. And Cuba was an ally of the USSR and received both financial and diplomatic help from them. Nikita Khrushchev, the leaders of the USSR, was worried that the US would attack communist rule Cuba and overthrow Fidel Castro, the president of a small island nation of the coast of the US. Then the leader of USSR decided to convert Cuba into Russian base and planted nuclear missiles. The president of US, John Kennedy, then ordered American warships to seize any Soviet ships heading to Cuba in order to warn USSR. These events brought the two superpowers close to a nuclear war. A clash seemed imminent, which came to be known as Cuban Missile Crisis. Okay. The Cold War was a period of conflict, tension, be- confrontation between USSR and USSR, their respective allies, both the Eastern blocs and the Western blocs, after the old war was divided into two super blocs, USSR. Now the point is the causes of the Cold War. What were the causes behind the Cold War? First point is struggle for power. What is the meaning of struggle for power? What is the meaning of struggle for power? Struggle of power, which means a violent competition for power between two superpowers. Okay. Next is ideological conflict. Ideology of USSR was that time socialist communism. Ideology of US was capitalist democracy. But remember students, they never came to direct war or hot war. It was called as a proxy war, because they never came to a direct blow or war. Cold War was represented by freedom versus totalitarianism, dictatorship. Okay. So these are the Cold War background. First World War happened in 1914 to 1918. Second World War 1939 to 1945. Second World War was between Allied powers and Axis powers. USSR, Britain, France, Axis powers, Germany, Italy, Japan. The end of the Second World War 1945. What was the reason? The bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in Japan by US. It forced Japan to surrender. Okay. Now next point is the emergence of the two power blocks. Okay. One is Western Alliance. Western Alliance is also known as North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO, and was created in 1949 by US. And then Eastern Alliance, it is known as the Warsaw Pact. It was led by the USSR and was established in 1955. So world was divided into two blocks, Western Alliance and Eastern Alliance. Now the smaller countries also joined other alliances of the two super blocks for their own purpose, because they were promised of protection, weapons and economic support against war and rebels. Achha. Now the NATO countries in 1949 had 12 countries. They were Belgium, Canada, Denmark, France, Iceland, Italy, Luxembourg, Netherlands, Norway, Portugal, United Kingdom, United States. Now 29 members are included in NATO countries. Warsaw Pact and members were Soviet Union, Albania, Poland, Romania, Hungary, East Germany, Czechoslovakia and Bulgaria. Okay, next point is what is the logic of deterrence? Why it was so important to know? Because it was an essential military strategy of both the superpowers and a crucial ingredient in winning the Cold War without fighting World War III. Deterrence is a strategy for combining two competing goals, countering an enemy and avoiding war. That means balance of power. So here it is, deterrence means prevention of something, mainly war. Yet the logic of deterrence means when both sides have the capacity to respond against a war and it causes so much destruction that neither side can afford to initiate it. This logic was followed by both the superpowers for avoiding an indirect or direct war, because they did not want any other war. Okay, the two superpowers wanted to extend their sphere, influence and dominate over as many countries they could. Now the next point is the areas of the Cold War. Arena of Cold War means about regions where Cold War was fought. There were many events occurred, but here we only focus on the most important wars. First one is Korea War 1950 to 1953. You have to remember these three words: Korea War, then Berlin War 1952 to 1962, Congo War early 1960s, So Cold War therefore refers to the areas of crisis and war which threaten to occur between two superpowers. Okay. Now, though they did not cross certain limits, but at the same time they did not want to back down. Some of these areas like Korea, Vietnam, Afghanistan where huge lives were lost also. Thus world was spread on the verge of nuclear war and global hostilities. So students, lastly you have to remember about Korea war, Vietnam war and Afghanistan war. So these are the areas of the Cold War. Last one is anti-ballistic missile treaty was an arms control treaty between the United States and the Soviet Union on the limitation of the anti-ballistic missile system. Okay. Next point is challenge to bipolarity. Okay. What is bipolarity? The word bipolar stands for two poles. In international politics, bipolarity referred to the division of the world into two powers. It was in this context that non-alignment offered by the newly decolonized countries of Asia, Africa and Latin America, a third option, was not to join either alliance. Now the question is, why did NAM countries did not join the either alliance? Because they wanted to keep distance from the military alliances led by US and by the Soviet Union after the end World War II. First reason was to service national interests rather than the interest of two superpowers. Second reason was to upkeep the sovereignty of the nation to take independent decisions. Third reason was to follow the policy of non-alignment. Okay, these countries are also known as third world countries. The non-aligned movement was formed during the Cold War as an organization of states that did not seek to formally align themselves with either the United States or the Soviet Union, but sought to remain independent or neutral. The first NAM summit conference took place in Belgrade, Yugoslavia in September 1961. Now the point is, what are the objectives of NAM? Okay. Objectives are national independence, abolition of imperialism, colonialism, sovereignty and an end to racial discrimination and apartheid, territorial integrity, effective cooperation with United Nations and security of non-aligned countries in their struggle against imperialism, colonialism, new colonialism, racism. Okay. Next point is challenge to bipolarity second part. Students, you have to remember five members of NAM countries. First one is India Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru that time, and Yugoslavia President Joseph Broz Tito, Egypt President Abdul Nasser, Ghana President Kwame Nkrumah, Indonesia President Sukarno. NAM made a valuable contribution in reducing the intensity of the Cold War as an active role in mediating between the two rival alliances in the cause of peace and stability. Okay. Last point is second last point is new international economic order. New. What is new? New is mainly to promote economic development among the developing decolonized countries. This order was demanded by the non-aligned movement. Okay. So, new was a set of proposals put forward during the 1970s by some developing countries through the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development to promote their interests by improving their terms of trade, increasing development assistance, developed countries, tariff reductions. Named countries did not seek to formally align themselves with either the United States or the Soviet Union, but sought to remain independent or neutral. So the challenge for the most of the non-aligned countries were categorized as the least development countries or LDC. Okay. Achha. New International Economic Order part 2. It was to be more economically developed to lift their people out of poverty, because without economically sustained development, a country could not be truly free. And it was possible when these countries could acquire control over their natural resources like raw materials, and when their prices were linked with the prices of products imported from the developed countries. With this realization, neo-organized United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, UNCTAD. In this way, LDC countries signed Belgrade Economic Issues in 1961, then become a pressure coup. So, it was the role of new international economic order during Cold War. Okay, last point is India's policy during Cold War. Ultimately, what policy India had taken during the Cold War? India's foreign policy towards the US and USSR was twofold, staying away from the two alliances, first and second, raised voice against the decolonized countries becoming part of this alliance. Moreover, India tried to reduce the rivalries between two superpowers from escalating into a full-scale war. So, students, there are the main important facts or topics of the chapter, which is called as Cold War Era. Hope you understand this chapter. If there are any queries about this lesson, you can contact me over Zoom. Details will be forwarded by the school. Thank you.